Warning, this video contains flashes and bangs. Sometimes I'm asked a question that transforms the way I see CSGO forever. For instance, Sasha K asked me what the maximum amount of time you can spend flashbanged in proper matchmaking is. What an excellent question. First of all, I needed to calculate how long you can remain flashed from a single flashbang. This was harder than it sounded. It's not a simple case of chucking at the ground, crouching and looking at it. I got slightly better times from a botched throw onto a sack of grain, which bounced onto the ground and then back up a bit before exploding. Clearly, I needed to get as close to the explosion as I could. I got a great result from this flash, which bounced off a wall and exploded in my face, but nothing could beat no clipping into the ground for an almost perfect view of the blinding explosion. Maybe you could do better than that by a few milliseconds or so, but I'll stick with this one. Now we have to decide where to start and to stop the timer. It takes a few frames before you're entirely blinded, and then it takes a while to fade out again at the end. I decided to time the duration that you're 100% blinded. No shoddy half flashes here, thank you very much. Using this fine specimen, upping the contrast to ensure 100% flash coverage and recording at quarter speed for maximum accuracy, I was fully blinded for exactly 9 seconds. Or at full speed, 2.25 seconds per flash. Indeed, a flash fit for a king. Now to picture a dream game. There are two parts, the warm-up and the game itself. Warm-up has the potential to be 5 minutes long. Let's assume 9 people connect immediately. More than enough to deliver a solid barrage of flashes. Warmup can be made to last the full 5 minutes if one person takes at least 4 to join, which, let's face it, often happens in matchmaking. Even with 9 people on for the full 5 minutes though, we can't be blinded for all of this, since it took me at least 1.875 seconds after spawning to buy, to throw, and for the first flashbang to completely blind me. After this, it's perfectly possible to remain blinded, provided a perfect flashbang is thrown every 2.25 seconds after the first. It would take a minimum of 133 perfectly timed flashes to keep the flashy blinded until the warm-up's timeout. This would cost $26,600, easily achievable between the 10 people in warm-up, and with plenty to spare. They could lob a flash every second at him, just to be sure. Wouldn't even have to be that accurate to ensure full flash coverage. So, minus the time before the first flashbang detonates, this leaves 298.125 seconds in warm-up that a player can remain entirely flashed for. Not bad going. But after the 5-minute warm-up, the game doesn't start immediately. There are 4 seconds of freeze time. If you die and respawn within this time, then you can still move about and shoot your teammates in the face, as I'm sure we've all done at some point. You can't buy flashbangs during this time, but it turns out you don't have to. If you're holding a flashbang and let it go immediately before you're frozen, the flashbang detonates 1.75 seconds later and lasts for 2.25, so it does still cover the whole of this freeze time. Isn't that convenient? In total, I count 298.125 seconds plus 4 for the freeze time, a grand total of 5 minutes, 2 seconds, and 125 milliseconds of flash time during a 5-minute warm-up. Not a bad start. Now for the game itself. Although limited to, say, 1 smoke pipe per round, the same limit doesn't apply to flashes. You can buy as many of these beauties as you can afford. It's almost as though Valve wants us doing this, until 20 seconds after the round begins, whereupon the buy time ends. Now, I constructed this beautiful graph of all my workings and calculations, but I'll simplify it with this not-so-delightful chart. This is a single round. You have the freeze time here, where you can discuss strategies and tell your teammates how bad they were the previous round. Obviously you can't throw flashbangs at this point, but you can buy them.
Thanks, mate.
During the first 20 seconds of the round, you can buy and throw flashbangs, so it makes sense to chuck as many as you can at this stage, and to ensure that, when it ends, everybody still has 2 flashbangs each. And this is the rest of the round, where you can't buy any more, but the remaining 20 flashbangs equipped by everybody can, and will, be thrown. The rest of the round is the simplest. 10 people on the server, 2 flashbangs each, equals 30 flashbangs altogether. No, it isn't, it's 20. 20 flashbangs, each combined for 2.25 seconds, equals a total of 45 seconds. The buy time is a little more complicated. It takes 1.875 seconds to deploy and for the first flashbang to explode. After this, it's easy for another to be thrown every 2.25 seconds to keep the victim 100% blind. But it also makes sense to throw a flashbang at the very end of the buy time, because like we mentioned earlier with the warm-up's freeze time, you can keep a player blinded with flashbangs thrown during the buy time for the 4 seconds that follow. And then we can move on to the 45 seconds of flashes as everybody uses theirs up. To put it simply, 10 flashes are thrown during the buy time, 20 are thrown after. A total of 30 flashes, which equate to a total of 67.15 seconds total flash time. At $200 per pop, or bang, this is $6,000 a round that will need to be spent on flashbangs. The most money-strapped round is, of course, the pistol round, where the players on the server have a combined total of $8,000 to play with. Easily enough. This means, in a 30-round game plus 5 minutes of warm-up, with perfectly timed and placed flashbangs, we can keep a man completely flashbanged for 38 minutes, 35 seconds, and 875 milliseconds. That's not bad going. Now the questions. Why do 30 flashes only blind for 67.125 seconds, when they should last for 67.5? This is because of the odd timing the last one during the buy time is thrown at to ensure that everybody is still equipped until the last possible moment. And, although 67.15 seconds per round is the theoretical maximum, is it doable? And can it be done without gaps, effectively rendering the victim 100% blind for over a minute solid? The answer to both of these is yes, even during pistol rounds when each player is limited to 4 flashbangs per person, enough for 2 during warm-up, plus another 2 for the moment the buy time ends. It works out perfectly. If you started with $1 less in pistol rounds, then it wouldn't be possible. It's almost as though Valve had planned for this all along. Too convenient, if you ask me. And what about the time taken for the other team to reach the flash fest? A single team can sustain a solid flash for the duration of buy time, and then for an extra 26.5 seconds beyond that as well. This is more than enough time on any map for the other team to reach the unspeakable act of evil and to contribute with their own flashes. Even if it wasn't, if he who is to be flashed is willing to help with this noble quest, then he could perhaps start shuffling over to the middle of the map the moment the buy time ends, to help the other team to reach in time. It's a real shame that Vertigo has been removed, as it had insane potential for trick throws, with each player plummeting to their death as they depleted their flashbangs. In style. All in all, you could pull off the perfect game of flashes for the low, low cost of just $207,000. And why limit it to one person? Have 2 people staring at the grenade and double the blindness. It's probably even possible to have 4 people huddled around each and every flash. And if overtime is a possibility, then we could carry this on indefinitely. Though I think a normal 30 round game would be enough to cause lasting damage. Probably both physically and mentally. Tune in next time, where I calculate how long you can use flashes to keep a player entirely deaf.